Oh, I was absolutely terrified. I remember it was across the job site. I was in another machine, and when I finally got close enough, it spun around to where I can see the cabin. There was no one in it. As an operator, when you see nobody in the cabin, a machine's moving, that's usually a bad sign. And that's when I was told that it's a robot.
Robotic restaurants, self-driving cars, at-home drone deliveries. Artificial intelligence and robotics are beginning to change the way we move, the way we live, and the way we work.
So as of now, we're running 100% autonomously.
This is Clayton Maute. He's only the second person in the United States to be certified as a robotic equipment operator. But as construction booms and companies turn to robots for their efficiency and safety, the demand for people with Clayton's training will only increase.
As some old timers used to tell me, it's just another tool in your toolbox. So the more I know, the more versatile I am.
Once again, technology is changing work as we know it. Are you ready? These are the blue, white, and no-collar jobs of today and the future.
We are at Built Training Facility, and here we test robots and tweak them, get everything we can out of them. I got my first job when I was 18, pouring concrete at an Air Force base. And shortly after that, I started running equipment. And I've pretty much been hooked ever since. I mean, being a heavy equipment operator, I'm always playing with Tonka toys like I'm a little kid, but now that they made them robots, it's even cooler. So an REO is a robotic equipment operator. With that, we do all the safety checks for all the robots. We set up all this big barricade. We shoot points for the geofence. And then after that, all that's done, it's just hitting start and managing the robot as they dig autonomously.
The robotic excavator will cut an impeccably straight ditch better than any of the most experienced human operators can. While it does this, Clayton can monitor its progress and its path remotely.
Here I have a full 360 view on all cameras. And even though I don't have a physical eye on the robot, I can always see exactly what it's doing by this animation. You got your spoils, your trench already dug, where your spoils are going, and where you're actually going to dig as well. And it'll actually give me a time frame on what time this trench will actually be done. To the T. It does dig a very straight trench, and it digs it to the depth that you want it to, and it digs for as long as you want it to, so really speeds up the day for us. While the robot is running autonomously, it gives me time to do all the other responsibilities and things that I have to do.
The autonomous machine is meant to be a force multiplier. As it digs this trench, Clayton can do more intricate work in a second machine that the robot is incapable of doing. He can also begin prepping for the next dig or the next day's work.
We are shooting the geofence. The geofence is a sandbox that the robot gets to play in. So right now we are going, hitting 4 points, making a square. The geofence is just as important as the physical barricade that we put up, but the geofence lets the robot work in that specific area. It won't swing out of that. It won't track out of that. If it comes to a trench and the geofence that I shot ended, the robot will just stop moving and wait for further instructions, pretty much. The robot just digs. So I have to do everything for the robot to dig.
Built Robotics, the company that created the technology, has partnered with construction unions to provide a 30-hour REO training program for heavy equipment operators like Clayton. Once certified as an REO, those operators are likely to see an increase in pay.
I'm really excited about it, only because I have done the REO program and I've seen what it can be. I mean, we're pretty in the premature stage of these autonomous machines, especially out on construction sites, so I like it that I'm here in the beginning and not when it's, you know, the cool thing to do. Hello.
How Good, how are you?
I think the future of construction definitely is looking towards more autonomous machines. If you can eliminate any sort of accidents, a lot of companies I think are gonna go towards the autonomous way.
The Occupational Safety and Health Administration reports that construction site workers suffer the third highest injury rate of any industry. Robots are impacting the way people work. In Clayton's case, by working alongside them, the job's made safer for him.
There's no one in the machine to get hurt. There's no one need to be around the machine to get hurt. So you've taken all the danger right out of it.
Clayton is on the forefront of a shift in what construction jobs look like. While the technology is still new, robots could help address construction's labor shortage while giving opportunities to experienced workers like Clayton to learn new skills and earn more while working in safer environments.
To see a large piece of equipment like an excavator run with no one in the cab is just a real cool sight to see, and I'm really glad that I became a part of it. I had two robots running at one point, and they were like watching two little kids play, like make sure they don't do anything dangerous, just keep digging.